welcome to Mobile Tech Info. Today I'm going to do a hands-on on two devices that I have with me, Lumia 735 and Lumia 720. We're going to do a comparison and see what is what with these two devices. This is the older one and this is the newer one. Let's find out how they stack up to each other.
Like this, hold up. Yo, can you feel me, God? Can you feel me, star?
So welcome. As I said, I have two devices with me right now. Here we have the Lumia 735, which is the newly released Nokia Lumia last month. And here is its predecessor, one which I kind of told you that I have lying around. It's the 720, and that's the predecessor of this 730. And in this video, we're going to compare the two of them, because obviously they have a lot in common since they're based in the same price range. And are targeted at the same group, actually. So let's start with a size comparison first. We see that the Lumia 735 is a little bit taller than the 720, but not by much. I think a few little millimeters. If we look at thickness, they're both almost equally thick, around 9 millimeters. Weight is also something that's pretty similar. This one's 130 grams. 130 grams, and this one is 128 grams. Now, if we look at screens, there we do see some differences. This one is a clear black AMOLED display, and this one is a clear black IPS display. Also, this one has a WVGA resolution, and this one has a 720p resolution. We also see there's a difference in size, whereas this one has a 4.3 inch screen. This one has a 4.7 inch screen. Although this one is HD and this one is not, the quality in this panel is still very, very admirable and very nice to look at, with good viewing angles and bright colors and good saturation. Well, of course, that's been a little enhanced in this one. Also, you see that the navigational buttons are on the screen, and here they're still on the handset itself. So that sets them apart a bit. But apart from that, the styling is the same. For instance, if we go to the back, let's talk batteries first. This one has a slightly larger one, 22 milliampere hours, and this one is 2000. The camera, however, is both 6.7 megapixel Carl Zeiss lens with a, as I mentioned before, a very large aperture, which lets in a lot of light, which gives you nice and sharp photos. At 6.7 megapixel cameras, the cameras are and the lenses are actually identical, so there's no changes on the back. I guess the biggest changes is on the front, because this one has a 2 megapixel camera just like in the Lumia 920, but this one has a crazy 5 megapixel camera, which is really good for selfies and of course enables you to film 1080p HD screens. Another hardware change, of course, is the keys, as you can see. So this one are actually made in black, and this one have the same color as the shell, but you're missing a button. So 720 has a camera button, 735 does not. So that's another detail that that differs them from each other. Some extras: this one has built-in wireless charging, wherein for the 720 you have to get an extra casing, an extra cover to enable that. Also, this one has the much favored glance screen, as you can see, and this one does not. Well, screen sensitivity is the same, so you have the double tap to wake feature. And of course, operating system is slightly different. This one is still in Lumia Black, and this one has Lumia Denim, which enables a few extras in the camera, and you have some extra features in the UI. But other than that, the setup is the same for both of them. Something that I did notice is, of course, the difference in speed. This one has a Qualcomm 400 chipset, Snapdragon 400. It's a quad-core 1.2 gigahertz clock phone. And this one still has the older Qualcomm dual-core with 1 gigahertz of speed. And also, this is, of course, 512 MB RAM, and this one is 1 gigabyte of RAM. And the differences aren't that notable, so if we open up the phone app, then you know this one may be slightly slower, Open up Cortana. I think that's gonna make a difference though. Yeah, Cortana is a lot now faster on the other one. Even though this one I just booted up. Let's try that again. Cortana, 1, 2, 3, go. Yeah, so now this one was taking longer. So the Cortana launch speeds are about the same. Is there something else we can try? Oh yeah, Nokia camera, let's try that. Both taking a while, although it's a lot faster on the 735, as you can see, by a few seconds. So there are some performance differences here and there, but browsing to the UI, multitasking, that's equally fast actually, I think. Yeah, that's equally fast, yeah. One last thing that I found very interesting is, of course, gaming performance. Let's see if we can do one of those. Let's see. Because one game that particularly was a bit slow on the 720 to start is Subway Surfers, and it takes a really long time to start it up on the other device. So we're gonna try and do that. Let's see that here. And this one is almost done. Still taking quite a while though. This one is done. Okay. Looks nice. And this one is still going. And now it's done. Yeah. Let's see. Graphics are about the same. So graphics is about the same. Yeah, so you see resuming also takes this one a little bit more time. But all in all, those are like the key differences between these two. So this one is slightly slower, but still no slouch when it comes to performance, battery life. Let's maybe try a website. Explore. So let's try a website, see how fast that goes. Both of the devices. And you see it was a lot up a lot sooner on the 735. But it didn't lag behind too much. Let's see, do they have a different version loaded up? Let's see. Let's see, let's go to the full website and see how we're doing there. What do three go? Yeah, I see the Snapdragon 400 is definitely a much faster experience on Windows Phone. Not that this is bad, but you just see that this is a lot faster performance also with reaction loading in the website. See zooming. Zooming is about equal actually on both websites, on both handsets. Yes. So this has been my comparison of these nice and refreshing devices. This one was very refreshing when it came out. This one continues the trend with the new feature, the 5-megapixel selfie cam. So that's pretty nice. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you know the differences between these two models now. They're both very nice phones again, and stay tuned for the next video. Catch you later.